IPv6 adoption has been increasing steadily, but IPv4 still remains widely used due to its long-established infrastructure and compatibility with older systems. So, what exactly is IPv6? Well, without getting too technical, IPv6 is the latest version of the internet protocol that allows devices to communicate over the internet. It's like a digital address that helps your device connect to other devices and services online. Method 1. Check network adapter settings. The first thing you'll want to do is check your network adapter settings. On Windows, you can do this by going to Control Panel, Network and Internet, then Network and Sharing Center, and finally change adapter settings. Alternatively, for quick access to network adapters, as demonstrated in the earlier tutorial, simply right-click on the Start button and choose Run, then type ncpa.cpl and press Enter. If your computer has two or more physical or virtual network interface cards, you will see them all. For example, our computer has two Ethernet interface cards and one Wi-Fi interface card, and only one of them is connected and active. Right-click on your active network connection and select Properties. Look for Internet Protocol version 6, TCP IPv6, in the list. If it's there and enabled, your system probably supports IPv6. Click on Properties and make sure that the Obtain an IPv6 Address Automatically option is also checked. Close these dialogs. Now, right-click on your active network connection and select Status. In the Status dialog, in the Connection section, you will see IPv4 and IPv6 connectivity. In the Status dialog, select the Details button. You will see the Network Connection Details dialog. Scroll down and look for IPv6 address and temporary IPv6 address. If you found them, it indicates that your system supports and is currently using IPv6. As you can see, the system on the left side of the screen supports IPv6, while the system on the right side only supports IPv4. If you only see the linked local IPv6 address, it suggests that your network card does support IPv6. However, it may not have received a global IPv6 address from your router or ISP. Note, when connected to multiple networks simultaneously, you have the option to prioritize their usage. In another video, which will be linked above and in the description, we'll teach you about this. Method 2. Using command line. Other methods to check IPv6 support include using the ping command in Windows command prompt. To do this, open the Start menu. Type cmd and run command prompt. First, ensure that the internet connection is established by typing the following command: ping google.com. If the ping was successful, enter the following command and press Enter: ping -6google.com. If you receive a reply, it indicates that your system supports and is currently using IPv6. However, since IPv4 is still widely used, your system will use both IPv6 and IPv4. If you don't get a response and the ping was unsuccessful, it indicates that your system is exclusively using IPv4. As you can see, the system on the left of the screen supports IPv6. Will the one on the right only supports IPv4. You can access more details of the network adapters, such as the IP address or MAC address, by using the ipconfig /all command. The information provided is identical to what we observed in Method 1 of the Network Connection Details dialog. Method 3. Use online IPv6 test tools. An easy method to check if your system is using IPv6 is to visit ipv6.google.com, which is Google's IPv6 site. If the site loads successfully, your device is using IPv6. Another way to verify IPv6 support is by using online tools. There are various websites like ipv6-test.com or test-ipv6.com that can check your system's IPv6 connectivity. Simply visit one of these sites and run the test. It will provide you with detailed information about your IPv6 connectivity status. If you found this tutorial helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more tech tips on CNATT channel. Thanks for watching!